In this video, we're going to talk about pivot tables and get pivot data function in both Excel and Google Sheets. It's pretty much the same exact function, so if you know how to use it in one, you know how to use it in the other. So I have this data set, so I'm going to go ahead and create a pivot table in both Google Sheets and Excel really quickly here. So I'll go under Insert, do a pivot table, Create. It's going to add a new worksheet. Under values, I'll have sales. And I'll use sum function in that. And under rows, I'll use region for now. And there it is, our total sales by region. The same thing in Excel. Go under Insert, Pivot Tables. Hit OK. Take sales, put it in values. Take region in rows. Let's quickly format these numbers to currency just to make it look nice. So first of all, let's just understand why we need getPivotData function to begin with and how exactly we actually use it. So the thing with pivot tables is because this data right now is connected to this particular source, what's going to happen if you change your source and update to different regions, this report will update as well. And as it updates, what's going to happen, these regions may not be in the same position. So for example, if you decide someplace to do some sort of formula using this grand total, like 20% of that, what could happen is when this updates, this grand total can actually move a line down or a line up, and then all of a sudden you're not pointing to the right cell anymore. And that same idea applies if I use any other number here to do some sort of calculation. To avoid that issue, we can use getPivotData function. And the way we do that, we use equals getPivotData function, and the first part of this function is the value, and the value is the actual value field from the pivot table you want to grab. If you don't understand the difference between value fields and non-value fields in pivot tables, I recently made a pivot table video using Data Studio. I really encourage you to take a look at that. But if you already know what a value field is, in our case right here, my value field is sales. So I'll go ahead and provide that as text, so in quotes, comma. And the second required argument here is any cell from the pivot table. So basically, you want to just give it a starting point where it's always going to be there. So typically, that would be the first cell in the top left corner of your pivot table because you're always going to have something in there. So at this point, if I just go ahead and close parentheses, hit enter, you'll see I get this amount right here. And that same exact thing works the same exact way in Excel, right? So if I go to my Excel spreadsheet and paste that same formula here, now in my case, the pivot table in Excel is not in A1, it's actually in A3. So I'll change that. Upper left corner, hit enter, and there it is. We get this total amount. Now that's how we get the overall grand total. Now, if you want to get one of these numbers in the middle, let's say the one for West region, then what I can do, I can go back here and add a comma, and we follow that by the name of the field. And what that field means, let me hit escape for a second, is the column from which these values come from. So in this case, that's this region. So I'm going to go ahead and do that. So I'll do comma. And again, that's text region, like so, comma. And then you have the actual item name. So the item name means the actual value you have from here. So for example, if I want West, I'll just type West. And if I enter, I'll get that amount, as you can see, for West. Now, because these are text values, you can type those values in a cell and refer to those. And what I mean by that, I could go here and type West, and then go to this cell, and instead of hard coding this, I could just point to this D4, which is where the value actually is. And if I enter, you'll see I'll get that same amount. Now, the advantage of this, if you wanted to get all of these, maybe I could copy and paste those values here. And now, because the first one is Midwest, this number is Midwest number. And now to drag this down, I'm going to make sure I lock this A3 cell. So I'm going to do $A, $3. This is that first cell in the pivot table. Upper left corner, which is always going to remain the same. So we'll just keep it the same by using dollar signs. And at this point, if I just drag this formula down, you'll see I'm going to get the right value for each one of these regions, because what happens if this goes to the next line, it points to the correct region and we're going to get our values. And at this point, it doesn't matter when you update your data, maybe these things will move up and down or whatever. It doesn't matter because we're still going to go find the right value field in the right region column, and we're going to match this, which is in this case, northeast. Now, in this particular case, in my pivot table, I only have one row breakdown like this. So let's go ahead and delete this, and I'm going to go back to this pivot table, and let's add something in columns too. So I'll go ahead and do something like sales rep. And now I got my reps listed in columns and regions in rows. As a matter of fact, I'm going to switch these. I'll put this here and this here, like so. So let's say this is your pivot table and you want to point to a particular value from here. So yet again, if I just go here and do my get pivot data function, doesn't matter where exactly, but I'm going to do it here. We're going to start with that same sales value field, comma. We're going to point to that same upper left corner of the pivot table. I'll add some dollar signs here, comma. Then the field I'm pointing to. So again, let's just start with that region example. And then comma, and then the particular region I'm after. So if I do West, this should give us the total for West region. This is the total, as you can see, which is this total down here, 2.5 million or so. Let's just make this formatted like this so it looks better. So that's this amount down here. Now let's say you want to grab the actual number for Grace here. So to do so, you'll go back to this, add a comma, and then you use the next field you want to point to. And the field, I'm going to hit escape for a second, the field name here is, see, sales rep. So I'm going to go ahead and go back to this and do sales rep, comma, and then the actual sales rep we're after. So I said I wanted to do Grace, I'll do Grace, hit enter, and that should give us the amount for Grace in that particular region. Now, even if I go back to this particular pivot table now and move region, say, to rows, so now everything is in a different shape in the pivot table, right? But this number is still gonna work. It doesn't matter because we're still gonna grab the right value. And then again, if you don't want these values to be hard-coded, maybe you want this to say like West here and Grace here. You can of course go to your formula and point to this West here and to this cell. Instead of Grace, I'll point to this cell, G6, which is the one that has Grace. I hit enter, I'm gonna get the same amount. And at this point, if you wanted to get, let's say, a few other people here, let's say all of these are in West region, you can drag it down. That would work just fine. And if you wanted those same names, let's say in Midwest region 2, then you could of course do that too. And if we just double check for Jennifer Midwest, which should be, see, Midwest here, Jennifer, 105,815.87, and that works just fine, as you can see. Now, all of this works exactly the same way, obviously, in Google Sheets. Now, let's say you work with dates. So dates are not going to be probably identical in Google Sheets and Excel. It's still going to be the same idea, but values may not match the same way. So I'm going to give you that difference so you can see what I'm talking about. So if I take this data right now, I'm going to get rid of this. And I'll take this and I remove this region and sales rep from here. And I'm going to take this date column. So just to refresh your memory here, this is my dates. I'm going to go back here. I'm going to take that date column and I'm going to move it to rows. And what Excel does, it will by default make this groups for you. See, like by year, by month. Now I will take this quarter out of here. And I'll take this date out of here, so I'll just have years and months. And I'll probably, I can open these, but I'm probably also going to move years to columns just to make this easier to read. So there it is, we got year to year by month. Now notice here, this is called years, space, open parentheses, date, close parentheses. So whatever that column name is here, and here as well. Whatever you have. Now, don't look at what I have in this particular case. You're gonna have to check what you have in that particular position, and that's what you need to use. So now if you wanna grab a value from this pivot, again, you're gonna use that get pivot data function. And again, the field is sales, the value field. The cell is this one. Upper left corner, so I'll use dollar signs just in case I want to drag this down, comma. Then I'll start with fields. So for example, if I do year, space, date, like so, comma, and then I'm going to point to the year I want to use, and for this I'm going to do 2021. So right now, let's just close and hit enter and see what happens. So as you can see, I got an error. So if I have an error, that means I made a mistake someplace here. Let's go find out what this should have been. So I'm gonna click on this. See, right here, it's not year, it's years. So I'm gonna go back here and switch this to years. And now, of course, it works and it gives us the total for that year. And if you want this to be a total for a particular month, let's say for June, then you go back here. And before I do that, let me just double check. It's called months date. So I'm gonna go to this and I'll do months, like so, comma. And then I'll use June. And there it is. That should be our total for June in 2021. And of course, it works. So this is how I got to this in Excel. Now let me do this in Google Sheets too, which is honestly not going to be different, but you just have to pay attention to values. So if I go to Google Sheets here, I'm going to get rid of this and I'll take this and remove this region out of here. I'll replace this rows with that date column. Now Google Sheets doesn't automatically group your dates, but you can still manually group them. I can right click, go create pivot date group, and then you can choose how you want this grouped. So I'll do year month. So now you can see in rows here, I have date and then dash and then year dash month like this. So you wanna keep in mind all the spaces, all the special characters, all those things. Now again, if I wanna grab a particular value here, I can just go get pivot data and then I'll do sales column. I'll point to this cell. I'll use some dollar signs here just for good practice, comma, and then the column. So in this case, this is the column name. So that would be date, space, and then this dash and then year, month. comma, and then finally the actual value I'm after. So let's say I want to do this 2020 December. So I'll do 2020-DEC. Of course, this is all a single line. It just goes to the next line just because I'm zoomed in. So if I enter, you'll see I'll get that value, 321,995 right here. That works just fine. Now, if you want to do it more like Excel, when I have a separate year and a separate month, you can do that too. So if I get rid of this for a second, so what I can do here, I can go back here, right click on this, go to my group options and just do something like month. And then I can add the date column one more time and take the second one and group it by year. And then we could take one of those and move it to columns section. Let me zoom out a little bit here. So I'll take this year, move it to columns. And this way it will look pretty much identical to how that Excel pivot table looked like. And yet again, see, we got this date dash month and date dash year. So we need to refer to those. So if I just go here and do equals get pivot data, and I'll take that. Oops, let's get back to this. I'll take that sales value field and I'll point to this cell. So as usual, by default, if I just do this much, that would be your grand total, meaning this total down here. Then I'm going to go back here and add a comma. Let's do year first. So I'll take date dash year. Again, don't forget spaces have to match exactly the same way. And let's do the value. So I'll do 2021. So I'll hit enter. Apparently, I didn't get the name of the column right. So I'm going to go back and fix that. See, I have parentheses open like I did in Excel. There is no parentheses here. So we're going to do this. And there it is. Now you can see this gives us the right value for this year. And of course, if you want to get a particular month, you can just go ahead and do the other column. And I'll do it for June right now. And as you can see, that works just fine. I'm going to X out of this sidebar because it gets on my way. At this point, I have my values. I have my pivot data. And of course, as usual, if you want to have some sort of values here, so let's say I'm going to go June and I'll just do a few months here. Then we can, of course, go back here and instead of hard coding 2021 here in the formula, we can point to the cell. And then instead of hard coding June here, we can point to this cell. And then we can drag this formula down and that should give us the right month year combination total right there. One last thing I'm going to mention here. If you update your field names, you need to make sure you come back and update them in your formulas too. So what I mean by that, right now, this here is called date dash month. So let's say you go here and just rename it to like months. So now you're going to see I get a bunch of errors because we don't have the right column name. So I can go here and instead of having this date month thing, now I have to use that new name months. And if I drag this down to update the rest of these, you should see that they work fine. And there it is. That's your get pivot data function. Let me know if you have questions. And as always, thanks for watching. Please subscribe and I'll see you in the next one.